Proverbs chapter 4, a father's wise instruction. Hear, O sons, a father's instruction, and be attentive, that you may gain insight. For I give you good precepts, do not forsake my teaching. When I was a son with my father, tender, the only one in the sight of my mother, he taught me and said to me, "Let your heart hold fast my words. Keep my commandments and live. Get wisdom, get insight. Do not forget and do not turn away from the words of my mouth. Do not forsake her, and she will keep you. Love her, and she will guard you." The beginning of wisdom is this: get wisdom, and whatever you get insight. Prize her highly, and she will exalt you. She will honor you if you embrace her. She will place on your head a graceful garland. She will bestow on you a beautiful crown. Hear, my son, and accept my words, that the years of your life may be many. I have taught you the way of wisdom. I have led you in the paths of uprightness. When you walk, your step will not be hampered, and if you run, you will not stumble. Keep hold of instruction, do not let go. Guard her, for she is your life. Do not enter the path of the wicked, and do not walk in the way of the evil. Avoid it, do not go on it. Turn away from it, and pass on. For they cannot sleep unless they have done wrong. They are robbed of sleep unless they have made someone stumble. For they eat the bread of wickedness and drink the wine of violence. But the path of the righteous is like the light of dawn, which shines brighter and brighter until full day. The way of the wicked is like deep darkness. They do not know over what they stumble. My son, be attentive to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Let them not escape from your sight. Keep them within your heart. For they are life to those who find them, and healing to all their flesh. Keep your heart with all vigilance, for from it flow the springs of life. Put away from you crooked speech, and put devious talk far from you. Let your eyes look directly forward, and your gaze be straight before you. Ponder the path of your feet, then all your ways will be sure. Do not swerve to the right or to the left. Turn your foot away from evil.
Thank you. As followers of Jesus Christ, we are gathered to worship and confess our beliefs. We believe that the Bible, as originally written, was God-breathed, both verbally and in every part. It is the final authority of our faith and lifestyle. We believe in one God, the creator of heaven and earth, that in the unity of the Godhead, there are three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We believe that the Lord Jesus Christ, God's Son, was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of a virgin. He lived a sinless life, died and rose from the dead, ascended bodily to heaven, and is coming again to rapture his saints and establish his kingdom. We believe that the Holy Spirit is a divine person, equal with the Father and the Son and of the same nature. We believe man was created by the direct act of God and not from a previously existing form of life. By voluntary transgression, he fell from his state of innocence. Consequently, all men are now sinners by nature and by choice. We believe salvation of sinners is divinely initiated, holy of grace, and accomplished only through the mediatorial work of the Son of God. It is not of works or religion. We believe in the local church and the universal church, which is the body of Jesus Christ. We believe water baptism is the single immersion of a believer in water, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, to show his identification with Christ in his death, burial, and resurrection. It can do nothing for his salvation. We believe that the Lord's Supper is the commemoration of his death until he comes. We believe in the bodily resurrection of the just and the unjust. Believers by faith in Christ will spend eternity in the presence of God, unbelievers in everlasting punishment. We believe that every believer should live for God and separated from the world, and by the aid of the Holy Spirit should walk in Christian love and holiness. We believe that Jesus Christ commands his church to make disciples of every nation. We believe that the greatest thing man can do for himself is to love God above all, and the greatest thing he can do for others is to show them how to love God above all.
Have you been? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Okay, mayong agaliwat sa tanan. It is a privilege once again makapamalandong kita sa pulong sa Ginoo. Man shall not live by bread alone, no? But in every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. This time is a continuation sa aton nga meditation from Genesis chapter 12 verses 1 to 9, which is just a few verses back. This time it's verses 10 to 20, which we entitle The Sojourn in Egypt. No? Sojourn in Egypt. Mabalanda na karon kung anong mutsing ganun sinang nga word. Pero this is somehow a continuation or a next chapter, next level sang journey ni Abram from his land, which is from the land of Ur. So just a recap, gitawag siya sang Ginoo from his land. And then he was brought to a land of promise, which is Canaan. And we have learned that he also encountered challenges along the way. Here in verses 10 to 20, it starts with these words. Okay, verse 10. Now there was a severe famine in the land, and then Abram went to Egypt. Okay, so now we see a much more severe test. Okay, so dito, malain man ang set sa mga challenges. This time, kumbaga mas level up, kumbaga. Because this time, it is already famine. Kasi it's not just a famine, but severe famine. May kagutom, no? Probably nag-heat wave, no? Nagkalamatay ang mga tanom. And there was no other option for them. Kag ang may pagkaon lang gid that time was Egypt, no? I think we know nga ang Egypt may suba na da sila, which is very big ng suba, ang Nile River. And amupagid ni ang grabing challenge kay Abraham, because he was not only away from his country, and now he is now being threatened by hunger sa iyang promised land halin sa Ginoo. So, mo man ang grabe, no? Gindala ka sa Ginoo, pero daw magutman ka. So, what would you do? Or what could you have done? Do kalayo ni siya sa promisa sa iya, no? Nga, you will be blessed. Kaya tiyan ba sa Ginoo, you will be blessed sa sinang lugar, pero nga may kagutom, nga may kapigadohon. Nga nag-follow ka man sa Ginoo, pero nga pigado ka, no? Or nga ginagutman ka. So, muning challenge nga nagabot kay Abram. Ano yan ang iyan na paminsar sa itong mga tiyon, no? Kung siguro, kung sa flesh, sa tawhan, nun lang mambal, tayo nano ka man Ginoo man, sunod-sunod kasi mo, pagutman mo diya, nano, gin give up ko na tanan, dason, way pa kwarta, no? Isa may mga muna ang mga fleshly, ang mga halambalon kita, no? Posible man, temptasyon na siyang hambalon naton. His faith must have been overturned and he must have questioned God hundreds or thousands of times. Kisa gina-question ta ng Ginoo, no? Especially kung wala na uno daton bangko, wala na uno daton bulsa, ang aton nga vault da sa balay, o mga grocery mo, naubos na tanan, bugas mo, wala na, nagubas na, no? So, ano yan ang ginubra ni Abraham? Now, ambaldere, si sojourn to Egypt. He went down to Egypt to sojourn them. Ano ang munting ganun sang sojourn man? Okay? Ang word nga sojourn, munting ganun sina, temporary settlement. In other words, although hindi man gid ang Egypt ang gin-promised land sa iya, nagkadto lang to sa Egypt for temporary nga stay. No, amo nang meaning sang sojourn. Okay? For a while lang. Kung sa aton pa bala nagano lang siya, nagbisita lang, no? O nag-detour lang siya anay sa sina nga lugar, sa Egypt, no? But he did not forget God's promise. Ang iyang mata, ang iyang goal ara gyapon to sa Canaan, sa promised land, Pero tungod sa kagutom, tungod sa kabigaduhon, nagkadto lang sa anay, sa iban nga lugar, sa Egypt. Serving God has many obstacles. Following God has many obstacles. But sometimes we need to find a temporary shelter that we may complete the journey. Serving God may also mean spending, no? Or using resources. Kag makita ta diri bala ang dapat ta gitandaan nga hindi lang di si Abraham is hindi lang siya solo traveler, but he is a father of the family. He is a provider, no? Sa iya family. Kung i-relate na niyang hindi lang gali si Abraham, concern niya iya kaugalingon, may ginapakaon man siya ng mga tao. Kagpag-serve niya sa Ginoo, gin-consider yaman sila. Tandaan ta, gindala niya iya pamilya. But then, no, wala igin pabayaan no, iya family. Gindala niya sa Egypt for them to survive. Kung i-relate na mo, may bilang tao galagad sa Ginoo, no? May nabatian kasi sa mga pastor's kid or mga missionary's kid or mga bata sa mga Christians, no? Kag hindi taman kalipatan ang ilang needs, no? Especially sa example ni Abraham nga ara ang kagutom pero way niya wala yagin pabayaan ang iya pamilya. Damo ko mga iban mga gabiter bala, no? Nga mayo pa mo ni example gambal bla nga may pagalagad si tatay ga serve siya pero kami no wala kami isang amon mga needs damo na ko na nabatian no nga lumalala ng mga drama man bla kisa pero no if I reflect sa life ni Abraham da makita ta diri ang iya example kag wala yagin pabayaan ng iya mga pamilya kag ang ilang temporary needs iyaman nga gin atipan without no without giving up his calling without giving up his destination without calling God's without giving up God's word and God's command. Okay, though the condition of this present life was unstable and troubling and that our bodies and are carried here and there, yet we still fix our eyes to the destination and our faith unshaken. Amo man na sa ito, no? Hindi tagin may iwasan kung kaysa economic, financial, physical, or other needs might lead us to other places, no? Iti, dito ta kakita obra, dito ta kakita shelter, dito ta kakita kwarta, no? Okay, sige, go ahead, no? But do not lose sight of where God wants you to be, no? Next, verse 11. Upod niya yung wife, no? Kag along the way, probably before sila nag-sulod sa Egypt, which is weeks kung lakton, no? Pila ka semana. Hambal niya si asawa, I know that you are a beautiful woman. Ang asawa, gali ni Abraham nga si Sarah, although may edad na, nang gwapa gyapon, no? Beautiful woman. She is beautiful even though she is old. We know nga kung siyempre nagatigulang na ang tao, kagmiskan ano pa kagwapa or kagwapo, ang katigulangon kung kaisa mo nang mag... kumbaga magpanas no sang beauty na ginatawag pero kabalo ta subo nga tungod sa science and technology may mga technique na para nga stay beautiful or stay fresh pagyapon miskan nagaedad na but here to it's in some for some reasons na maintain ni Sarah no ang iyang pagkagwapa. And some people say nga tungod ni kay wise ka bata no wise ka busong no muna nga na maintain niya but some also say nga tungod lang niya tungod giniya sa grasya sang Ginoo nga nagwapa gwapa siya gyapon even until old age amo man nga hindi man ta makibot nga magambag ka gani Israelites or mga bata ni Abraham mga gwapa kagwapon na sila generally no Iti si ilang ginikanan, ambas sa Bible, may ano na, may beautiful faces. So, guwapa siya, ambas ang banan niya, niya basi pagsulod dito sa Egypt, nang maluyagan ka sa mga Egyptians, no? Kag, ambas sa verse 12, pagsulod dito, mahisa sila, patsyon ko nila, kag ikaw mabuhio nila. So ining si Abraham na nagutman pero ginkulbaan man siya sa iya nga kadtuan. It may seem unfair for the Egyptians, no, kung ikaw man being Egyptians, paminsaran ka nga murderer ka, no. No, unfair man siguro, no. Pero we can also say nga ang mga Egyptians tungod siguro sa ilang pagkabantog bala sa they are being cruel, no? Probably ruthless, powerful, naglapta na sa bilog ng kalibutan ang ilang integrity as cruel people, murderers, no? So probably mo naging consider ni Abraham, and he may have heard about the wickedness of these people. Although hindi man na siya fair tani because God does command nga hindi ta dapat maging judgmental sa iban, be gracious to others, no? Hindi ta mag-conclude, mag-prejudice. He also wants us to guard ourselves against unknown people. Hindi lang ta basta-basta bala maghatag sang tanan-tanan sa wala mo pa nakilala, strangers kumbaga. But ini naman yang iya tam-an naman, no? Because he endured others. Why? Because in so thinking, he had this unreasonable anxiety that caused him to involve himself in another wrong. And worst, he involved his wife. Sa tam-an niya kakulba, sa tam-an niya kapraning, sa tam-an niya ka-judgmental sa mga Egyptians, ginsugo niya ang iyang asawa magbinutig. Now, verse 13. Say to them, you are my sister. Hambala sila nga hindi ta asawa. Mag-utod ta nga dua. Para nga hindi ko nilapat yun. No? So, makita ta diri nga si Abraham, no? Now, though nakita eh naman tani paano siya gin-preserve sang Ginoo sa amutong point, no? Sa Kanaan. Naging lead siya, no? Ginpakamayo siya somehow, kalabot siya sa Kanaan. This time though, it seems nalipatan niya, no? Nalipatan niya ang providence ng Ginoo. He took matters into his own hands for his own preservation, no? Ang nag-iya-iya lang siya. He used deceit. Nagbinutig siya kag hindi lang siya iya pagit asawa, gintuduan niya magbinutig, no? To tell a lie for the preservation of his life. When we are faced with difficult matters or deadly threats, it appears there is no way of escape. We make rash judgments and tend to bring others at risk. By this example, no? Makita taman nga kisa sa aton pagka thoughtless and prayerless, madalahig tapagid ang iban. No? May mga times nga nagpadaso-daso kita sa aton mga desisyon, kagang iban nga tao na ano ta pa, no? na harm ta pa sila. We place them in harm's way. But here we see that sa difficult times gali dapat, when we are in doubt, we must seek God's Spirit and God's counsel to seek and ask the Lord and be sober, no? Be sober. But sige nun, kalma lang, no? Hinay-hinay lang, hindi magpadaso-daso. Unlike Abraham at this time, nga nagpanik siya, no? Kag nag-resort siya sa isa ka sala to preserve his life, which he knows that God alone can do. He feared too much and too soon. Amo ni ang pagka-fearful ni Abraham. Although he is the father of faith, but makita taman nga he is also a person who is fearful. Okay? Next, verse 15. And the woman was taken into Pharaoh's house. Okay? So, titungod kay sister lang siya, ni Abraham, ginkuwa siya. Why sila gin, kumbaga ginbulag sila. E ti kung asaway sila tani, hindi sila bulagon. For the fear of saving his own life, he subjected his wife to the peril of adultery. You know, ang gesture nga ni, this is already a gesture of preparing her to be Pharaoh's wife. No? Kiti nagopan siya mga Egyptians and sa tunga time, dodamo, bilangaga recommend sila sa hari, no? Kag ipreparar ini sila kung sino dang pilion, maybe isang hari. Oftentimes, again, as I said, when we are afraid, we panic and put others at risk and do not rely on the grace of God. No? Kag, this is an important realization nga sa aton kung kaisa nga mga pagkahadlok nang we have to consider ang effect sina sa iban, no? Sa family mo, sa close people sa imo, what harm, what risk might it bring to them? Okay? Next, verse 16 and 17. We see there that Pharaoh dealt them well, but the Lord afflicted Pharaoh. So, maayo man taning pagtratar man ni Pharaoh sa ila. No? Ginmayuan man sila, gingaan sila sa ilang needs. But, unknowingly, innocently, ginsilutan si Pharaoh. Nangiya pa ni Malay. We can conclude here nga gin-honor man sang Pharaoh, sang king, si Sarah. No? Hindi man siya gin-treat as a harlot. As from the word itself, nga honor, no? This was a gesture nga hindi siya i-treat as a harlot but as a wife. But at this time, Abraham might have said nga safe na ko, no? Safe na ko, kag secured na ko sa sining lugar. Pero kung minsaron mo, grabe man nga siguro gina-cover niya ang iyang tagipusoon nga mag-react. Kay ti kabalo siya nga ang iya wife. Asawahon naman sang iban, di ba? Isn't that something that might have make him more afraid, di ba la? Di ba muna dapat ang mas hindi niya gusto? Pero though it seems dari nga para kay Abraham, mas importante sa iya ang iyang survival kaysa sa iya marriage or sa iya binga nga ano no nga ang purity sa iya wife. Kag ang hindi ta pagidi siguro mabasa directly nga ang promise pagid sa Ginoo, di ba? Kay ti ang promise sa Ginoo kay Abraham is siya ang may bata, no? Siya ang maging father of all nations, of a great nation. So kung asawahon ng iya wife sang Pharaoh, meaning sina si Pharaoh na nakaroon ang kwan, ang father of all nations, di ba? So, behind the scenes, nang God sees something different. Si Abraham niya, para siya safety, security, no? Okay na ta, but ang ginugali, ilain niya yung makita, no? Kisa mo muna sa ato, no? Nang abita, okay na ta, we are well, but if we try to seek God's will or God's, God's plan, may lain siya galing na plano. So, anong plano? Dari sa Ginoo, silutan ang Pharaoh. Gaan sa masakit, gaan sila plagues, no? Ang basa ang ibang version, plagues. Kag, amo na, nang hindi gusto sa Ginoo, kay tungod may ginaptigana siya kay Sarah, kay Abraham, as their own seed, no? Ang isa pag ako nga na insight din makita, an insight that we can get is sometimes we tend to be craving for for the favor of kings, no? Sikat, Manggaranon, or the high echelons of society, mga high, people of high statute or stature or positions. Though we try to, run after those approvals, after those blessings of these people, which is not literally bad, no? Bagani sa Bible, we have to reach out. Even si Paul nag-reach out sa mga kings, kay King Agrippa. But ang sala din ni Abraham kay ang iyang means, no, does not justify the end. Although ang entani is for survival, pero ang iyang means nga gingamit is telling a lie, no, and motivated by fear, which and did not only put to risk his wife, it also put harm to other people, to Pharaoh and his household. So nagmalasakit sila, wala sila kabalo nga ginsilutan sila sa Ginoo, no? But later on they discover, I don't know, it could be somehow God has a way to tell the king, don't touch this woman, this is the wife of Abraham, no? God might have revealed. And here we also see that God has a remarkable concern for His servants, His people. He will protect them even against the most powerful monarchs and leaders and rulers of this world. Miskan hari pa na siya, no? Why na sila say against the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We have a saying, Dominus Dominorium sa Latin, which means the King of Kings. God is more powerful. God can intervene on the courts of the kings. He can intervene sa palace, sa Malacanang, sa White House. He can intervene sa UN. He can intervene in those seats of power just to accomplish what he wants to be accomplished. Let kings also learn from this, to control their own power and do not abuse their authority and voluntarily moderate themselves. Okay? So here we see the hand of God, okay, in the king's court, no, sa most powerful seat of that time. So what happened next? The Pharaoh, the king, went to Abram and said, why did you not tell me that she is your wife? Now, again, we don't know kung paano yun inabalaan. Probably God told him. God spoke to the king, probably in a way that like a prophet. No, but he knew. He knew it after that plague, after the problems, the diseases. So, makita taman din nga, nagambal siya, why did you do this to me? Why did you not tell me that she was your wife? In other words, nga nagbinutig ka sa akon. Gin-welcome ta ka, gin-batiti ta ka, gin-pakaon ta ka, gin-mayuhan ta ka, pero gin-butigan mo lang ko. No? In other words, gin-sakit pagid ni Abraham ang balatsyagon man sang hari, sang unbeliever. No? And why did you say she is your sister so that I took her for my wife? Now then, kumbaga sa kay Pharaoh naman niya, ano gali ginambal mo ni ki para asawaon ko sa kag para silutan ko, no? Now then, here is your wife, take her and go. Makita naman din nga si Abraham way gasabat, no? He is silent. And matawag naman nga guilty silence. No, kung kaysa kung may sala ta bala, kagkabalot nga sala ta. Kag ang Ginoo nag-intervene, no? Kabalot ang Ginoo has somehow vindicated or protected or saved you or rescued you. Ang the best thing na lang git nimo nga may mo magipos ka na lang, no? Just keep silent. Just like Abraham, kabalo man siya nga may sala siya. Kabalo siya nga iyanitanan inimuan, no? Ang plagues, ang akig nga hari, no? Iyaning a thoughtless decision. So grabe, no? It just started with a fearful feeling and a thoughtless action. And then it went up to the worst nga may plagues. Tiyan mo kung bilog na plagues, tungod lang kay wala ka nag-pray. No? Tungod kay way ka nang ayaw bulig sa imo decision making. And this is why siguro mo kasi makambag ita, prayer is very important. No? Seeking His will, even it takes few weeks or a few days to seek God's will, it can save a lot of wasted money, energy, time, no? Efforts, tears, plagues, probably. It can even save wars and can stop wars. Just a simple time of asking for wisdom on decision making. And again, Abraham is not perfect. He is the father of faith, but he has made mistakes that we can consider not a good example. And that's the beauty of the Bible, no? The beauty of the Bible is hindi lang yang it just lists down the good things. It also lists down the bad things that the people of God did, no? Which would serve as also a lesson for us, and that we learned from this that God miraculously protected Abraham even though he wronged the unbelievers. Ang pinaka idea man sini is gin trigger mo, gin sakit mo, gin himuan mo malain ang king, no? Pero imbis mangakig siya, gin protektahan kapag itong Ginoo sa iya cruelty, no? Sa punishment. Tani kung ikaw ang king, di ba? What would you do to Abraham? Probably you just have to kill him or send him to prison because of this high level of traitorship nga ginhimo mo sa kingdom namon. Okay? But we see here that he was saved from cruelty, from judgment, from imprisonment. No? Kung sa ano pa, ikaw na lang mahuya, ano? Kung si Abraham na, siya na lang mahuya, nga grabe nga pabor ang ginatag siya sa Ginoo, imbis tani nga ginpatay na siya ni Pharaoh. Okay, kiti kabalo siya nga cruel ni siya eh, no? Yeah, pwede man lang to tani agawon ng iyasawa, patyon siya, and Pharaoh will just live happily ever after. But no, Pharaoh released him and even gave him a lot of money and stuff and camels and animals. That's why nagmangaranon manda si Abraham. So here we see the favor of God in a believer's life, no? In general, we are like Abraham because nakasala ta sa Ginoo. Sobra pa kay Pharaoh, di ba? God is greater than Pharaoh. We sinned against God and he must have punished us a long time ago. He must have thrown us into the Nile River or to the lion's den or hell. But he did not, because his mercy endures forever. And instead of punishment, we were led out of Egypt again. And we are even blessed by other lesser blessings apart from salvation na ginatag niya sa aton. So another mini picture sa aton salvation, of how God was rescued from Egypt, or Abraham was rescued from Egypt. And again, another mini Exodus, no? This is another Exodus story. This time, siya pa lang niya galing kagaya family. Na, di ba, Pharaoh man to, no? Sa Exodus, pagwa sila. This time, Pharaoh man and Abraham man, and God intervened man. Plagues man, no? Ginagamit pa ng plagues. So, dumayari di prologue, no? Prologue or in seed version sang Exodus, which again is a picture of our salvation, of how we are rescued from the hands, the grasp of darkness of Pharaoh, the power of our sin and power of our flesh and death, and set free going back to the land promised by God to us, we will live there forever. So this is the sojourn in Egypt. A sojourn means a temporary stay. For Abraham, this is a means. For Abraham, it's a means of survival. And there we see, number one, temporary diversion. Okay? He diverted, but his eyes are still fixed with a goal that God has set for him. So may mga setbacks ka, may setbacks ko, ang imulawas, hindi nakasustener, siguro for the meantime, okay, go. Go to Egypt. Okay? But your eyes must not be taken away from the land of promise. Next, unreasonable anxiety and thoughtlessness put others at risk. Tandaan tagid, no? Bad decisions, prayerless decisions will not just harm us, but it may also harm our loved ones and other people. Number three, God intervenes even in the most powerful places, no? Malacanang, White House, Kremlin, UN, lapit na election, even the COMELEC, the ballots, even there, no? God is sovereign and he can intervene in those places that we can simply rely on his being in control. No? Number four, though guilty, we are rescued from cruelty. And this is the last. Ang kanami sa grasya, kay biskan guilty na kita, may sala kita, nakobra kita, napoke ta, na-hurt ta ang power, ang God, ang punisher, no? But imbis nga ipunish kita, ang nabaton ta paya is salvation and emancipation or freedom from sin. So, grabe lang ito ang pabora ang sangginoo. Kag, why na gitiban nga rason nga amuna si Abraham, but the ultimate reason is that God was in his favor. No? Nagamuman na lang sa aton, the promise for us, the promise of for children of Abraham in faith is that God's favor is if we seek it, if we call upon it, then it shall be with us. And it shall be with us in our journey in this life of faith wherever we are. And even if we face pharaohs, no? People that might want to somehow kill, or cruel people, or oppositions, or problems, even famine, no? Even famine, even poverty, no? God supplies Egypt. God gives Pharaoh. God provides those needs that we don't know where it might come from, but they come, no? Okay, so ma-realize kung ga problema ka nagitbala sa journey mo sa imong kalanon, gutom or supplication, kisa magibot ka na lang, no? May Egypt nga magabot, may Nile River nga iula sa imo, may maabot lang sa imo supernaturally. And that's how God works, so that you will journey on, no? Continually sa iyang gina-destiny sa imo, which is the promised land. So that's for now. That's the journey of Abraham for now. For the next ones, let's watch out. And as we continue this, may we learn more about Abraham's life and faith that we can also apply in our lives today. Let's pray. Father, thank you for this version, another chapter, by the way, of Abraham's sojourn in Egypt, his temporary stay. May mga na-learn kami. Muna, Lord, kisa sa amon mga thoughtless decisions ng papahamak na mo ng iban, ang mga hari even, ang mga kingdoms. But help us, Lord, to be silent, to trust in you, to seek your guidance in every step of the way. And so that we won't risk others, but instead bring others to to your obedience and in faith with you, Lord. I pray that kung may mga times nga daw ara kami sa Egypt, kay tungod sang demand, sang among needs, may it be, Lord, nga hindi kami mag-rush decisions, maging maghimo sa mga thoughtless decisions, but instead maging blessing kami, kag we will not do unlawful things or lie nga para lang sa among selfish survival, but we instead become a blessing as what you have promised sa kay Abraham. Thank you, good Lord, sa imong pulong. Bless this in our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen.